Bonjour monsieur et madame, it is me le chef Reddit, today I have a special ala Reddit for you. Bon appétit and remember to subscribe.
What movie fucked you up mentally? I watched Blair Witch in my early teens with no concept of what documentary or found footage movie was. In my mind it was all real, the last scene was golden. Good Will Hunting. The part where Robin Williams explains to Matt Damon that although he knows almost everything, he will never know what it's like to look in the eyes of your best friend as he's dying in war or what it's like to lose a wife to cancer. Return to Oz. The Disney sequel to The Wizard of Oz. This movie is targeted at children. This movie is fucked up. It starts with Dorothy getting electroshocks in a bedlam asylum because no one believe in her stories about Oz. Then she returned to Oz, and then she encountered truly horrific monsters like the Wheelers, fuck the Wheelers, and the big bad is switching heads like you switch dresses and all the heads are alive and how my god how is this movie targeted at children? Fire in the Sky. I saw this when I was 8 or 9. I walked into my aunt's room during the operating scene, anything and everything that dealt with aliens freaked me out. When Unsolved Mysteries and the X-Files theme songs came on I would lose my mind and become really scared. Saving Private Ryan, as a child my parents would only allow me to watch Disney movies, and so when everyone was out of the house one night since they were at my cousin's house was right next door so they usually always left me alone for a bit, I turned on the TV and Saving Private Ryan came on, thought it was still a Disney movie and proceeded to watch it, Jesus fuck my tiny brain wasn't ready for that trauma. Edit, I read almost every one of the comments and want to thank all of you for sharing your experience and sharing your own stories, very interesting to see other people's views on stuff like this. What's Eating Gilbert Grape? I grew up in a very similar situation, like, spookily similar, just a lot less good looking. My mother was overweight and I just knew she was gonna die in our old house like that. Scared the shit out of me. Requiem for a Dream, still get bothered by some of the scenes in that. Watership Down. My parents thought it's just a cartoon movie, surely fits for an 7-year-old. I still don't want to watch the movie again, and I'm turning 29 next Sunday. I remember watching Hotel Rwanda as a freshman at my private high school. Embarrassed me because I realized the world wasn't even close to the way I thought it was. The Fourth Kind. For weeks after watching this it seemed like I would always wake up at exactly 3:33 a.m. and I was deathly afraid to be outside at night. I'm watching all of these by the way. Edit, I feel like I'm going to regret this statement. Edit 2, I'm a huge pussy when it comes to scary movies so some of these will be hard to watch. I watched Interstellar last night and that movie made me want to ask this question. Thank you to everyone suggesting movies. My phone is having a hard time keeping up. Edit 3, alright y'all, we're starting this journey tonight the 10th of July 19 follow-up, started with Gone Girl, it looked a little more mild than the rest. All I have to say about that movie is that they do a great job of shifting your opinion of the main characters. I recommend everyone watch it if you don't mind your trust issues being messed with. Flowers in the Attic. I was terrified of my mother poisoning me growing up. Fucked up shit. Life is Beautiful. Not a movie, but Black Mirror's Be Right Back episode. I lost my wife in 2011, and I had to stop watching that episode. Dear Zachary. If documentaries count, edit, anyone curious about watching it, I strongly urge you not to read any background or synopsis before doing so. Part of the power of this doco is the way the story unravels without any prior knowledge. Say 7N. It wouldn't fuck me up now at 40 years old, but when I watched it at 18, it left me silent and terrified for hours afterwards. I saw Cannibal Holocaust twice when I was 16, it was the first movie that made me sick to my stomach. Damn. Pee-wee's Big Adventure, Large Marge fucking scarred me as a child. I was like 4 to 5 and all my brother had to do was say her name and laugh and I would fucking Vietnam flashback a panic attack. Nightcrawler. Jake Gyllenhaal as a driven yet psychopathic and manipulative stringer is really intense. It fucks you up even more when you think about how greater than he still roams freely in the end, meaning we are all surrounded by such type of people, less than. Grave of the Fireflies. Best movie I'll never watch again. Jacob's Ladder and Enter the Void. Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind. I know it's not a movie that would fuck anyone's mind up, but to me it's very relatable and resonates with my life, so I found it very disturbing. When it comes to love, we all can commit the same mistakes over and over again and still want the same suffering, even if the happiness that it brings is just a few percent when compared with the suffering. If given chance, we will destroy our lives for that one person, even if we know nothing good is ever going to come. Her. Again, about relationships, it left a void in my mind. Very disturbing and depressing movie to me. Kids. Schindler's List, great movie, but it's disturbing to know it actually happened and wasn't just a screenplay. Trainspotting, I still can't watch any part of it with the baby. Hereditary had me sleeping with the light on for a while. Little nervous about seeing Midsommar. Irreversible. What has been seen cannot be unseen. IDK what the movies is called, I just know Robin Williams was in it, but the story was about a boy who aged way faster than his other friends, some sort of illness. I watched it when I was little and it just traumatized me so much. I can still remember watching the end scene, where the boy looked like a senior even though he just graduated and he looked so sad. Maybe I was just too young to watch this movie, I was about 6 or 7. Edit, thanks to you all I now know that the movie is called Jack. Edit 2, thanks for the gold, kind stranger. Dead Poets Society. It starts with such a hopeful tone and just completely punches the viewer in the face with reality. While I was never genuinely horrified by it or anything, The Brave Little Toaster had some pretty morbid moments. It went from happy, cheesy and generic kids movie to car genocide, killer clowns and themes of becoming obsolete and worthless. It's not the most scarring film out there, but it definitely wasn't what I was expecting for a movie about household appliances. You want to feel like shit tonight? Watch The Road. That is by far one of the most fucked movies I've ever seen. It's best described as a great movie that should never be watched a second time. AI. It left me feeling completely hopeless. Manchester by the Sea. The scene where he meets his ex and she apologizes while he tries to keep it together hit way too close to home. And also the one in the police station. Great movie though, Baby Affleck is absolutely phenomenal. Oh, and Jaws. It took my 10-year-old ass quite a while to get back in the water. The Mist. Iron Giant ruined my life for 2.5 years. The Deer Hunter. The movie just gets crueler and harder to watch. The Boy in the Striped Pajamas. Asterisk American History X asterisk. It was the first time that violence for the sake of racism became real to me. That scene, Norton Stomp, made me realize how fragile life can be, especially when confronted by another human. You know how The Walking Dead was trying to show us that humans are the real monsters, but it got really fucking annoying because, like, dude, we get it? This movie makes that point so effortlessly and with such grace. I was fucked up for weeks trying to process the movie. I think I was in high school. That one movie, Caroline with the puppet parents or whatever. A Clockwork Orange. How could it not? Also, Last House on the Left. What a horrific rape scene. I had a full-blown panic attack because of it. Old Boy. The Green Mile. 120 Days of Sodom, Salo. I was on a disturbing movie streak and this one broke me, couldn't get past the shit scenes. Also, the end of Megan is missing, that fucking barrel. Melancholia, for one. The whole theme of the movie is depression and hopelessness and there's no benefit. Beautiful movie but real pretentious and yeah, no payoff. Hurts from beginning to end. Also, Annihilation. That made me question stuff more. The lines of, it was destroying everything, not destroying. Changing, this happens in real life too, except not as fantastical obviously. Some new organism comes into an environment and takes over, thrives, but stomps out the native species. From there, the environment changes in order to adapt. Is that bad? Or is it just our bias of trying to preserve the natural? It's interesting. Human centipede. I couldn't eat for a while after that one. Pan's Labyrinth. Warning spoiler, when the little girl died, I was pissed off for about a week. I couldn't stop thinking about it, and when I did, I started getting irritable with my friends, family, and coworkers. Everyone thought I was nuts. Edit, I added the spoiler tag. I hope it's not too late for someone. Warning spoiler, I also forgot to add that my own daughter was pretty much the same age at the time, so that got me all fucked up. Thanks for the silver stranger. Requiem for a Dream. Amazing movie that I can never watch again.
Thank you for watching. What was your favorite answer? Do you have a better one? Comment it down below. Au revoir.